Hello, welcome back to my channel. I am Kat Woods. So I'm going to upload a video, one that has been laid upon my heart. I have seen just recently a sweet sister mention something in the comments to me, and I've seen this quite a few times, heard this quite a few times from many, many people, felt this myself. So I know, like, dear sister, you were not the only one. So I really just wanted to go ahead and just talk a little bit about what I read. Just really what I read. Sorry, there's a car driving by literally. Right there. So just give me a few minutes. But yeah, I wanted just to talk about what my feelings on it. Okay, so the question was, I feel guilty when I go to reading my Bible. Like, I really feel guilty from past sins, just, you know, maybe sins you just did today, you know, just that guilt of I'm a sinner, I should not be reading, I should not be holding this Bible. Like, it's just, and that feeling, sister, brothers, whoever is feeling like this, you guys, that is from Satan. He wants you feeling less than. He wants you feeling like you're not even worthy of the Bible. That's literally, he wants to keep you purposely away from the Bible. And that is a very, very smart and strategic way for him to come at the Christians like that. Children of God like that, period. So, what I want you to do, okay, when you're ever, I felt like that, and for the longest time I didn't know that's what I was feeling. Like, I didn't know, I couldn't pinpoint what the feeling was. That's my issue. I'm really not good with emotions and identifying emotions. I'm learning. The Lord's helping me. He's helping me understand what each emotion is and why I'm feeling this way. So it's, anyways, veering off topic here. But whenever you go to sit down and you want to get excited, but you can't find yourself getting excited, you can't concentrate on reading the words in the Bible because you're just crippled with guilt, crippled with you're reading and it tells you shall not break the law and all these commandments that you know you have broken in the past. You may be breaking them right now. Please close your eyes whenever you get that feeling. Ask for forgiveness. Our Father Abba is merciful. He understands where you're at in your life. He understands your walk. If you would just do one thing for me, one thing, go and read just the book of Genesis, Joshua. The Old Testament is so enriching for new Christians. So many new Christians are only told to read the New Testament. The Old Testament has so many life lessons for us today. Yes, it is the Old Testament, but you can learn so much. King David, he broke every commandment that his heavenly Father told him not to break. And if you continue to read on through his story, sisters, brothers, he was forgiven. He was forgiven and called the man after God's own heart. So if someone like that can be forgiven, what makes you think you are not deserving of the Father's mercy and forgiveness? What, myself, we all can come to our Father every single day. If, and that's what's so important. Well, I'm going to finish. We can come to our Father every day and ask for forgiveness. Like, that's what we are supposed to do. And when you ask for the Holy Spirit to come into you, the Holy Spirit is the one that starts convicting you. The Holy Spirit is the one that starts telling you, like, no, you're not supposed to do that. You're not supposed to say that. You're not supposed to be here. That's the Holy Spirit. That is when we start, as Christians, growing on our spiritual walk. Okay? And when the Holy Spirit convicts us, what are you supposed to do? What's the next step from being convicted? You repent. You repent of whatever sin you're doing. Like right now, if I you could just say, for instance, I just got in an argument with somebody and I said some very mean and hateful things to that person. I know they were wrong. I know that's sinful. So what's the next step to cleaning that out of my life? Repent. Ask the Lord's forgiveness. Tell him that you're sorry. And then wipe your hands clean, because he then wipes you clean. So you just, it's a learning process. I gotta be quiet now, someone's walking by. So I'm losing my train of thought here. I'm trying to keep quiet too, because many people are here walking and trying to enjoy the calm time. But so yes, come to him with repentance. And if you've seen inside my Bible, every day I come to the Bible, and right here, what about the passage that I'm reading makes me rejoice and give thanks? So whatever passage you're reading, do that. You can write this in your Bible. Please, 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 for those of you who are struggling, write this in your Bible as a reminder. Then, if you're reading a passage and something convicts you and reveals something in your own life that you should be led to repent, do that. Ask for the Heavenly Father's forgiveness, because He will. He will forgive you. And then right here it says, does the passage lead me to make a request to God for myself or others? All right, so sisters and brothers, what I want you to do and understand, no, we all make mistakes. Nobody's a Christian. Even if a Christian claims to be in the Word heavily, a pastor, there we go, a pastor, a man of God, he sins too every day, and he has to come to our Father for forgiveness for whatever he does. Our Father knows what we are going to do before we do it. He knows we've sinned. He knows that we're going to sin tomorrow. He knows that we're going to sin the next day. That's why he sent his Son down on earth. He sent down, I'll continue. He sent his Son down to forgive us. His Son bore our whole sin upon himself. He bore all the suffering. He bore all of that upon himself and took it from us. He took that pain and put it on himself, so we can then receive forgiveness. All right? So another thing I want you to think about, when Jesus was walking the earth, did he only hang out with people that were good, that were perfect, that followed the law every day to the T, that had these amazing rituals, and that just was 100% claiming to be perfect? Did he only surround himself with people like that? No, we know better than that. And if you read your Bible, you know 100% he doesn't. He had surround himself with the lowest of the low. I don't know if that's the right wording for that in that area, but he surrounded himself with lost sheep. There we go. He surrounded himself with lost sheep so he can show them the way, teach them the way, show them what's right, show them how to react to a bad conflict, show them how to react, what they were supposed to do when they did sin. You know, so you guys, read your Bible. Don't let guilt, don't let shame keep you from the Bible. It's extremely important. And it breaks my heart to hear that you feel that you're not worthy enough for the Bible. Do you know how many people on this earth are not allowed to have this amazing book in their hands, and they would do anything to get it? You have it in your hands, and your only excuse is, I don't feel like I'm worthy enough. Stomp that out, punch the devil in the face, and say, no, I am worthy, because I'm a daughter, I'm a son of the living King, the Lord of Lords, the Most High. Okay? So just open your Bible and start reading. Let the Lord show you how much you are worth his time, how much you are worth his love. And you guys, I know you have been looking at this book for the past 10 minutes now. This is an amazing book. A sweet, sweet, sweet sister, Carrie, I don't know how to pronounce her last name, Kill, I do believe, Kill, I'm horrible, horrible with names, sent me this amazing book that she wrote, and you guys, I have been hooked. Getting books like this to help you on your own spiritual walk is amazing. So, let me share a little bit, and look how beautiful the book is. She is so, so beautiful. Her love for the Father just shines. Oh, and her story is so, it grabs you. It grabs you and you just want to read. And what is so amazing about her story, you guys, she also has, and she signed it too. Thank you, Carrie. Oh, I am so honored. I am so honored to share it. She also shares scriptures, important quotes that match. It just gives you uplifting. When you're reading it, you really feel uplifted. I'm trying to get to a different chapter at the beginning so you can see it. I haven't finished it all the way, but here's another one. This is a good one. I wrote this down in my journal. Just you guys, if you would, please check out this book. You will not regret it. I promise you, you will not regret it. I love reading. I'm very, very conscious on what I read, so I'm very, very careful on what I put in my spirit. That's another thing. Watch what you read. People offer me all the times, can you do a review on my book? Can you go ahead and share my book on your channel? And I won't just do any book. So I only share a very spiritual books that would help people grow, and this is one of them, okay? So I do hope this video is okay, and I hope you can take something from this video. If you do have any questions, please leave them in the comments below. I love talking to you all. I am here always to help the best that I can, just to share my own thoughts and feelings with you guys. You're my family, and I love you to pieces. So don't let the devil keep you from the Bible. The Word of God is for you. This is how we grow. How else are you supposed to grow into a strong Christian? You can't do it on your own, and just going to church and not reading your Bible is not going to do it. Just watching YouTube videos is not going to do it. You can't live through by somebody else, from somebody else's testimony. You have to claim your own walk. You have to walk your own walk. Okay? So, I do hope this helps. I love you all. Remember, be a creative tool in our Father's art box today. I'll talk to you all later. Bye.